Welcome to a little update video on the vehicle that I've been working on. This is... It has gone through quite a few changes. Still doesn't have a name though, so... Yeah. This is what it looks like from the outside now. I think this is a lot better than it was yesterday, so... Even though some of the body issues haven't been addressed yet, like the holes in the body... overall, I kind of just resized it completely. Basically, I took the entire finger and scaled down the height of it. So, yeah, that's why it's a lot lower now. Also reworked the nose a bit, so yeah, that's a bit wider in the middle. So it has a bit of a flat part to it. Not gonna be too much doing in addition to that. Actually, I hope I don't need to touch the nose again, apart from a few cleanup things. Because honestly, I had to completely redo the front suspension after that, so yeah. Resizing it again will likely be a huge pain and have me do hours of work again on the suspension. But I think I should probably go from the front and then slowly to the back of the car to just showcase what I mean, the different things that need to be considered. So first up, the front spoiler. That's not the correct size. There are some issues with resizing the parts. Basically what happened is I used the transformation tool in Zmod and scaled the stuff down, which doesn't really transfer to GTA. I know how to fix it. It's like 1 or 2 minutes per part, and I just have to do it for the spoiler. It should be around the same size overall, at least from the from front to the back, but yeah, the left to right is definitely too wide. It should be more like the rear spoiler in that regard, so close to rears, but likely not really in front of them, or at least not too much. Speaking of the rears, there is a strange little bug with them. If I just take a look at them here, you can see that they are kinda blinking once once they are spinning. I don't know what happened to them. I didn't really do anything to them, but yeah, you can clearly see now that something is strange with them. So yeah, that needs to be addressed. Also, maybe we can repaint the middle part so it's respawnable by the player. The front suspension needs a bit more work, but overall it's mostly just missing the non-movable parts. I forgot to include them into the file, and they are their own separate thing now, so I'm quite happy that the stuff is overall moving with the wheels, so the suspension is working, it just needs the other parts and some fine adjustments. There are some dents in the body where the stuff will connect to the body, so basically some space has been made so it fits in. Otherwise, this is already have been a nightmare with all the resizing I had to do here. That suspension was usually 3 times the size because it used to be part of the trophy truck, which is really the only vehicle I could find with a suited suspension for this. So, the main body part, I don't really think I will do any changes to the proportions of it. As I already mentioned, everything I do there will be a huge pain in the ass for any additional parts. For the holes behind the player, I will likely try to copy the entire body shell, put it upside down and see if stuff aligns in a way that allows me to just weld everything together. Maybe some more carbony parts in the front here, but I don't know how to do those, so I'm not really bothered with them right now. If I find a part that fits well and that could be modified to be a nice fit, then I will consider it. Otherwise, I don't really care right now. Textures will come later. This is still kind of a... I've overwritten the bullet with this model, so yeah, it doesn't have the correct textures because it only has the bullet textures. So, yeah. Software. Also, we've got the exhaust, which will likely end up in those holes. I will shorten them so that it's not the wing end sticking out anymore. And then just try to make it look naturally and have as I was sticking out of air. This thing here is actually supposed to be a diffuser in the back, which kind of doesn't work right now. Again, the same resizing issues as with the front. Looks okay in the editor. I kind of just snapped it off the tyrant as I took its reverse light. So yeah, that's gonna be readjusted. I don't know if I will include it. If I find a few more carbon parts, then I will include it. Otherwise, it's a bit out of place. Wouldn't mind having this more as a let's say how to put it, as more of a classic vehicle which doesn't have too many details added to it. I think as in its raw form is already looking quite okay. So but yeah, I will try to at least make this fit. The rear axle, that's all going to go at some point. This is from an Omnis, doesn't really work with a vehicle. Likely going to use the same suspension as with the front, even though that sadly doesn't come with the axis that's usually transferring the power. So unless somebody finds me a better suspension to start with, I don't really know what else to use here. Shouldn't be too much of an issue, it's just a little detail there. In the back I will likely just put on an engine, so people can take a look at it through the hole here. Otherwise I don't really know what to do with it. If I try to close it, it's either looking completely stupid and out of place, or maybe if I just close it as it is, I could put the license plate over it. That might be an idea, otherwise I will likely just end up looking really stupid. But yeah, that's so far for this end. This is a little decal that needs to be removed. I didn't catch it yet, so that's not a big issue. One thing that could be a bigger issue is the middle part of the back here. That thing basically covers up the stump left over from the vertical rudder. Kind of had to cover it over because I couldn't find a better way to deal with that thing, but it's not the most beautiful thing. If you are looking at it closely with reflections and such, it's clear that there is a bit of a jagged edge where the transition is. So if you are looking really closely, you'll see that it's definitely not perfect. But right now I've got bigger issues to worry about, and I will also not be available over next week. Going to Insomnia, so until next Monday, don't expect to hear much from me. I could maybe take a look at a few things there, but don't expect me to put in hours there, so it's gonna be a bit on ice for the next few days. But overall, I'm quite happy with how far this thing has gotten so far. It's looking quite nice, especially after the use changes, and I think at some point it should be a decent addition to the server, and all people will like it. So yeah, that's for me now. Thanks for watching. Tell me your thoughts and in the comments or on the Discord. Of course, I will not make this publicly, as I think I mentioned in the beginning. So yeah, till next time. Bye bye.